So hello everyone. So today we are going to see the certain reactions of ether, and then we will move to the chemical properties of ether. So make a heading: preparation of aromatic ethers. Preparation of aromatic ether from phenol. Clear? So now see here. See, the first thing is, what is the difference between aromatic and benzyl? See, this portion is aromatic. If I write down here O and R, this is aromatic ether. Please remember this, because today I will discuss these two both. This is aromatic ether, and if I write down here ROR, this is benzyl ether. Okay. If the phenyl ring carbon, or if the phenyl is attached to the oxygen, then this portion we say as an aromatic ether. And if the phenyl ring is attached to the carbon and then OR, then it is called as a benzyl ether. Clear? So this is the basic difference between aromatic ether and benzyl benzylic ether. This is aromatic ether and this is benzylic ether. Now see here, preparation of aromatic ether from phenol. Now if you take phenol OH and if you react with NaOH, so what will happen here? This H and this OH will form here H2O. Yes or no? Because this is an acidic substance, this is in basic. So acid plus base, salt plus water. So your salt will be sodium phenoxide, ON. Clear? Now in the next step, if you start to react with RX, clear? So this is nothing but Na, this is X. So here NaX will be generated, and here there will be generation of OR. So I will generate here aromatic ether. So this is nothing but your Williamson synthesis reaction only. See here. In Williamson synthesis reaction, we are doing same only, no? So that we are using RONA, but here I am using RONA in this way. First I am preparing the RONA, then I am reacting with RX. Clear? So you can use the Williamson synthesis reaction for the aromatic ether also. This is nothing but ROR, and this we say as a aromatic ether. Clear? So this is very important. See, first here example, if I take first example, if I take here, if I take this phenol and if I met to react with NaOH, so what I will form here? H, here OH, I will form here what? H2O, and here I will form here ONa, plus here I will form RX. So what will form here? NaX. Here NaX will be formed. Here it will be forming OR. Now instead of here RX, if I use here CH3Cl, so here NaCl will be generated, and here there will be generated OCH3. So this is name is what? Methoxybenzene, or we say as a anisol. IUPAC gave it name is as anisol. So please remember this. This is a preparation of an anisol. Okay, or methyl phenyl ether or anisol. Clear? Instead of here, another example. If I take here OH and if I react with NaOH, so it will form here H, here form here OH, so it will form here H2O. So what it will generate? It will generate ONa plus, if I do the reaction with CH2Cl, so here Na, here Cl, here NaCl, here generation will be OCH2CH3, so it will form here ethoxybenzene, or it will form here phenetol. This will be generated. It will form here phenetol. Clear this part? Clear? So either here anisole will be generated or here be generated phenetol. So I can do the same. This is a Williamson synthesis reaction only. If I change the reagent, different compounds will be forming. If I take here CH3Cl, so methoxybenzene or anisole, and if I take here CH3CH2Cl, ethoxybenzene or phenetol. So this is the preparation of anisole or phenetol. Clear this part. This is the preparation of anisole or phenetol. Clear? So make a note this, take a screenshot. This can come in the exam. Okay, write the preparation of an anisole or a phenetol. This is one example. Or explain the preparation of Williamson synthesis mechanism by using the aromatic ethers. So this is the aromatic ether. In this way you have to solve the problem. Clear? So taken methoxybenzene or anisole, ethoxybenzene, phenetol. Write down this. Then I go to the next property, that is properties of ether. Properties of ether. Clear? Now if you see the properties of ether, see first, in first properties of ether if you go, the make a heading, that is reaction of ether involving CO cleavage. Clear? The reaction of ether involving CO cleavage, in that first we add on the reaction with HI. This is very important as exam point of view, as also the competition point of view. Clear? So before going to the reaction with HI, I will tell some key point, that key point to understand. See, SN2 story I have told you, yes or no? So what was the SN2 story? So see here, in SN2 story, no carbocation generation, no carbocation generation, yes or no? This is important, no carbocation generation. Clear? When no carbocation generation, so what will happen, especially I am telling here, so when no carbocation generation, so here I minus will attack on those species which has less crowding. This is for specially for this topic only. Okay, this topic you remember, this is very important, that here in reaction with HI there are two type of mechanisms will be used. When what will be used I will tell you, but understand before going to this topic, I would like to discuss first about SN2 and SN1. So in SN2 mechanism, you know, there is no generation of carbocation. So there will be no generation of carbocation. So where the I minus will attack? So I minus will attack on those species which has a less crowding. Which has a less crowding. In future, as I will teach you, which will use SN2 mechanism and which will use SN1 mechanism. Second part is SN1 mechanism. So in SN1 mechanism, what we are going to see, so SN1 mechanism means here carbocation will be generated. Here carbocation will be generated. So when carbocation is generated, so we know either we have 3 degree carbocation, 2 degree carbocation, 1 degree carbocation. Yes or no? So either 3 degree carbocation, 2 degree carbocation, or 1 degree carbocation. 1 degree carbocation is less stable. Okay. So I minus will attack on those species which forms stable carbocation. Which forms stable carbocation. Okay, so I minus will attack on those species which forms stable carbocation. Clear this part? So see, carbocation will be generated, and you know this is the stability of carbocation, yes or no? Stability of carbocation. Okay, so 3 degree is more stable than 2 degree stable than more stable than 1 degree. So here I minus will attack on those species which form stable carbocation. Clear? So I minus will attack on what? I minus will attack on those species which forms stable carbocation. Clear? Now see here. Here will come. Now reaction with HI. So on reaction with HI, reaction of with HI of whom? The reaction with HI of ether. So now see here. Here ether can come. See, this is ether. Okay. Either this can be 2 degree or 1 degree or 3 degree or benzyl. Just now I told you, no? Benzyl. So this portion is known as a benzyl. Here aryl case are, they are not asking. This case is benzyl. Okay. So either this R or this R. Either this R or this R. Any of the R can be either 2 degree, either 1 degree, either 3 degree or benzyl. Now student, this 2 degree they are not asking in the exam. 2 degree they are not asking in the exam. They are asking 1 degree and 3 degree. Okay. 2 degree they are not asking in the exam. They will ask either 1 degree or they will ask either 3 degree. Clear this part? So you have to discuss about 1 degree, 3 degree and benzyl. I will discuss this 2 degree also. But at the end I will discuss this. Clear this part? So reaction with HI. Understood now this? Okay. Now see. Why the issue creates? See, suppose I have this ether CH3OCH3 and this is HI. So what happens? This will be H plus and this will be I minus. The story comes, if I cleave here, this is also CO cleavage, no? So if I cleave here, this will, one, this portion gets minus and this portion gets plus. So this minus react with this H plus forms here what? CH3OH and here CH3 plus and I minus means what? CH3I. Clear this part? So when the symmetric ethers are coming, so you can either if I cleave in this way also, if I cleave from here also, product remains same. Now the question comes when asymmetric ether comes. The problem comes when asymmetric ether. So when asymmetric ether comes, then the problem arises. What the problem arises? Now where to cleave? Whether this to cleave? Whether if I cleave this, so CH3OH will be forming and CH3CH2I will form, or CH3CH2OH will form and CH3I. See, there are two issues, no? I can cleave in this way also. I can cleave in this way. If I cleave in this way, it will form CH3OH and CH3CH2I. Or if I cleave in this way, it will form CH3CH2OH and CH3I. So which is correct? This is correct or this is correct? Now it's an issue. How to cleave? So who will tell us? Now this will tell us. Their story comes. Whenever symmetric ether comes, not an issue. But generally questions will not come from the symmetric ether. They will ask from unsymmetric ethers only. Or the question comes, another question also I can tell. If like this ether is coming, suppose this is OCH2CH3 and CH3CH3, here also CH3. Now how to cleave? In this to cleave, so whether tertiary butyl alcohol will form and ethyl iodate, or I have to cleave in this way. So question comes, what to do? Question comes, what to do? Now this answers will be given by these stories. These stories, you have to remember certain 3 points. If you remember the 3 points, then you can easily solve the reaction of HI with ether. If you remember 3 points, 3 points should be remembered, should be mugged up and should be practiced well so that you can get the answers. These questions will come in the competitions also. Now see here, how to solve. See. So, in the first case, see here. In the first case, see here, case number one. Please remember, this is very important. If, see, this is ROR, okay? This alkyl group and this alkyl group, clear? No, ether. If any one of alkyl group, if any one of the alkyl group is 1 degree, if any one of the alkyl group is 1 degree, then SN2 mechanism will be followed. SN2 mechanism. Now SN2 mechanism, what it says? SN2 mechanism says there will be no carbocation generation and I minus will attack on those species which has a less crown. So here I minus will attack on, I written no here, that's it. So remember, if there is an, how to remember, 1 degree SN2, 3 degree SN1, clear? Second case, case number 2, if any one of alkyl group is 2 degree, if any one of the alkyl group is 2 degree, then SN1 mechanism will be followed, then it will be an SN1 mechanism. So in SN1 mechanism, what will form? Carbocation will be generated, and when carbocation will be generated, so I minus will attack on the stable carbocation. If it is a 3 degree, so 3 degree, 2 degree, it depends, we will see the reaction, okay. So whenever it is a 1 degree carbocation, sorry, 1 degree, if either of the group is 1 degree, then SN2 mechanism or 2 degree, SN1 mechanism. Now case number 3 comes, which has not been asked many a time, this is not so important, okay. So if if any one of alkyl group is 3 degree, then SN1 mechanism, sorry, here 3 degree, 2, question is for 2 degree. If any one of the alkyl group is 2 degree, now there are two cases. Here it can follow SN1 mechanism also, and can follow SN2 mechanism also. It depends on solvent. It depends on what? Solvent. If the solvent is, wait, I'll tell you. If the solvent is, say, ethanol and water, then SN1 mechanism. And if a solvent is acetone, then SN2 mechanism. So this you have to remember, very, very important. This, if you mug it up, it will be very easy for you to do the reaction. Clear? See, what is SN2 mechanism and SN1 mechanism? In SN2, carbocation, no generation. So there will be no generation of carbocation. When there is no generation of carbocation, so here I minus. Why I am talking about I minus? Because I am in a topic with HI. Okay, so here I minus will attack on those species which have a less crowding or less number of carbon. In this way also you can remember, I minus will attack on those species which has a less crowding or less carbon, crowding carbon. Next, SN1 mechanism. So in SN1 mechanism, carbocation will be generated, and when carbocation will be generated, so you know the stability series, 3 degrees greater than 2 degrees greater than 1 degree. So 3 degree greater than 2 degree greater than 1 degree, so this is stability of carbocation. So I minus will attack on those carbocation which is more stable. If there is a comparison between, if there is in ether, one is 2 degree and another one is 1 degree, so 2 degree I minus will attack. If there is a 1 3 degree and 2 degree, so on 3 degree it will attack who? I minus. So here remember, from I minus only, so remaining H will attack on the opposite. If I minus is attacking on the species which is a less crowding, so H plus will attack on those carbon which has a more crowding. You remember, from I minus automatically you get the answer for H plus also. Next here, in SN1 there is a generation of a carbocation. So now carbocation is generated, you know, the series of a carbocation, that is 3 degree greater than 2 degree greater than 1 degree. So now when 3 degree carbocation is more stable, so I minus will attack on those carbocation which is stable. So 3 degree is stable than 2 degree. Now suppose in ROR, one R is 3 degree, another R is a 2 degree, so I minus will attack on that R which is 3 degree carbocation. It will not attack on the 2 degree carbocation, because 3 degree is stable than 2 degree. So I minus will attack on the stable carbocation. So if there is a given 2 degree and 1 degree, so it will attack 2 degree. If both the 1 degree is given, so see, 1 degree, only 1 degree is given, so 1 degree is least stable. So SN1 mechanism will not be followed, SN2 will be followed. Okay, if both are 1 degree, then you have to see the crowding, and crowding tells us what? SN2 mechanism. Because if in the question SN, if in the question we start to generate 1 degree carbocation, 1 degree carbocation is least stable. So when 1 degree carbocation is least stable, so SN1 will not be followed, SN2 will be followed. Clear this part? That's why for 1 degree I am giving specially this SN2 only. We will see when I will discuss in detail. Understood this? There are 3 points. If any one of the alkyl group is 1 degree, then SN1 mechanism will follow. If any one of the alkyl group is 3 degree, then SN2, SN1 mechanism will be followed. And if any of the group is 2 degree, then 2 degree are 2 case. It can follow SN1 also, it can follow SN2 also. When it can follow SN1, now it depends on the solvent. These are the solvent. If in the question, they have given the 2 degree and they have given the ethanol and water, then SN1. So in SN1, I minus will attack on the those species which contain less number of carbon or where there is a less crowding. If the alkyl group is 2 degree, then SN2. In SN2, if solvent is acetone, then acetone means SN2 mechanism will be followed. Are you understanding or not? Clear this part? Okay. So now next we will go to the examples. Now these are the certain history you should understand and you should remember so that it will be very helpful to you. Now we will see one by one one case. Okay. Now see here. So I will go with the case number one now. Case number 1. So case number 1 says what? So case number 1 says if one of the alkyl group is, if one of the alkyl group is 1 degree, then which mechanism? SN2 mechanism will be followed. Okay. So in SN2 mechanism, no carbocation generation, and when there is no carbocation generation, so I minus will attack on those species which contain the less crowding. Now see here, this is CH3, this is O, and this is CH2, CH3, clear, plus HI. First I will do the reaction, okay. Now see here, here it contain one carbon, here contain two carbons, where there is a less crowding, here there is a less crowding. So I minus will attack on this carbon, so your generation will be CH3I. Plus CH3CH2OH. So it will not form CH3CH2Y. Okay. These answers will come. This will ask in you the exam. Okay. So here I have to cleave in this way only. I cannot cleave in that way. If I cleave in that way, so CH3CH2 plus and I minus. So I minus cannot attack only less more number of carbon. I minus can attack only less number of carbon because it is following which mechanism? SN2 mechanism it is following. Now we will see the mechanism. See the step number 1. Now I will show you why SN1 mechanism will not come. See, CH3O, CH2, CH3. There are two lone pair. So here HI. So here H plus and I minus. So this lone pair will give to this H plus. So CH3OH, CH2, CH3 plus and one lone pair. Okay. Now see here. What will happen? Now what we are thinking, see, this is CH3 OCH2 CH3, and here H. There are two possibilities. In step 2 it will be SN2 mechanism only. Okay. Now see what you are thinking. Now to satisfy this plus, either this will starts to get the electron or this will starts to gain the electron. Chalo. If I go to follow the SN1 mechanism, so I will generate in this way, no, either CH3 plus will be generated, OCH2 CH3, and H. So this is 1 degree carbocation, or I will generate what? CH3 CH2 plus, this is also 1 degree carbocation, yes or no? So both 1 degree carbocation is what? 1 degree carbocation is least stable, so this generation is not possible. So here SN2 mechanism, SN1 mechanism cannot be followed only. Then what I have to follow? I have to follow SN2 mechanism only, because I cannot generate here carbocation, because whatever carbocation I generate to stabilize this oxygen, so this oxygen starts to attract the electron for anyone. So here I cannot generate carbocation, because carbocation generated will be least stable. So when any product is least stable, cannot be generated. So what happened now in the second step? This I minus will come. Now this I minus will starts to attack on what? Which has a less crowding. See, here there is a more crowding, here there is a less crowding. So this I minus will attack on this carbon, on this carbon. So this will leave this place. Okay. So what will happen here? CH3I plus CH3. CH2OH, this will be formation which takes place. Here I minus will attack on those carbon which contain the alkyl group which has the less crowding or less number of carbon. So here there are two carbon, so more crowding is there, here there is a less crowding, so here it will be attacked. So this is its mechanism, understood? Now see, this is going, so when this is go, this nucleophile goes and nucleophile comes, so SN1 nucleophile is coming, going, So it starts to go slowly, slowly starts to develop the charge. But this I minus will not allow this CH3 to develop a positive charge. As this portion is going, this is coming from back. This all I have told you in SN2 mechanism. Okay, so there will be no generation of carbocation. Time is normal, carbocation generate karvano. As this portion goes, this portion will come from back. So nucleophile goes, nucleophile come from rear side, from back side. So this is the mechanism. Clear this part? Clear? So what I can write down? I can write down your summary as I minus will attack on those species which has a less number of carbon or less crowding. Clear? Another example, if I say, or if I take here, suppose if it was here CH3, then I minus would have attacked their CH3. Are you understanding or not? So this I minus will attack on those species which has a less number of crowding. Now here see SN2 mechanism is followed. Why? Because this oxygen want to satisfy plus. As this oxygen starts to gain the electron from this CH3, the slowly slightly positive charge starts to develop. But this I minus will not allow to develop only. This it starts to develop, it goes. So this happens in fraction of second. From here to here it happens quickly, directly. It will not get a time. It will not allow the positive charge to develop on this carbon. It will not allow. Okay, so this will not allow to develop the positive charge on this carbon. It will not allow only. As it goes, it comes. Okay, so there is no formation of carbocation. And SN2 mechanism means what? There are two nucleophiles are involved, no? One nucleophile, this whole nucleophile is going. So one nucleophile is coming from rear side. So this is SN2 mechanism. So that's what here I am writing here, SN2 mechanism. Okay, so this is a summary. That whenever you find the 1 degree carbocation, the I minus will attack on those species which contain less number of carbon, and remaining is opposite. So see, hydrogen is with another part. Clear? Write on this step number, case number 1. Then we will move to the case number 2. Clear? Okay, we will go to the case number 2 now. Case number 2. Now case number 2 says what? If one of the alkyl group is 3 degree, then which mechanism? SN1 mechanism. Yes or no? Now see here. This is COCH3. See, in the previous case there was not a question to generate the carbocation, because if carbocation would have generated also, would have not been formed, because there the carbocation was generating was 1 degree and 1 degree is least stable. So there is not a question of forming only. When they cannot form, they will go with SN2 mechanism. So no carbocation generation. Yes or no? Now here we will see, if one of the alkyl group is 3 degree, now see this is a 3 degree alkyl group, CH3, here CH3, here CH3. Clear this part? And here I will do the HI. Now see directly mechanism only I will show. Or first I will show the how to do the reaction. So here I minus will attack on those species which form stable carbocation. Here see, here either this will form CH3 plus or this will form this. So here there is formation of 1 degree carbocation and there is a formation of 3 degree carbocation. See, if I remove this, if I do the cleavage here, so I will get here CH3 plus, so 1 degree carbocation, or I will form here CH3 plus. So CH3 plus is more less stable than this, because here this formation is 3 degree carbocation. So this is more stable. When this is more stable, so I minus will react with this. So this will be the products, tertiary butyl iodide, and the formation will be CH3OH. Okay, so this will be the reaction. Instead of tertiary butyl alcohol, tertiary butyl iodide will be formed, because this I minus will attack on those carbon which is more stable. So this is CH3 plus, and this is C plus, CH3 and CH3. Who is stable? This is stable. So when this is stable, so here I minus will come and here OH will come. Sorry, here H will come. Okay. So this will portion will contain O and here H will come. Clear this part. So who is more stable on that species, I minus will get attack. Clear? So this is something about your tertiary butyl iodide. Now we will see the reaction. Mechanism. Understood this part? Okay, so see the mechanism. Suppose
I have C OCH3.
CH3, CH3, CH3. There are two lone pair. So here HI. HI will provide me as H plus and I minus. So this H plus will attack here. So here C O H. Here CH3. Here plus. Here CH3. Here CH3, here CH3, okay, and there is one lone pair. Now, this oxygen wants to gain the electron. So, there are two sides from which oxygen can gain the electron. Either this oxygen will start to gain the electron from this carbon, or this oxygen will start to gain the electron from this carbon. If oxygen starts to gain the electron from this carbon, so here formation will be of CH3 plus, understand? If it starts to gain the electron from this carbon, so this will release as CH3 plus. If not, if this oxygen will starts to attract the electron from this carbon, so there will be formation of this C plus, CH3, CH3 and CH3. You know this is a 3 degree carbocation. So when 3 degree carbocation is more stable, so this will be only formation, because formation occurs where there is more stability. So this oxygen will starts to attract the electron from this carbon, not from this carbon. So what will happen? The generation will be like this. The generation will be CH3OH plus C plus, C plus, here one CH3, here one CH3 and here one CH3. So there will be formation of 3 degree carbocation. Are you understanding or not? So there will be generation of 3 degree carbocation. And the second step, this is step number 1. Okay, in second step what happened? This I minus will attack on this 3 degree carbocation. So here CH3, here CH3, here CH3. So this I minus will attack from here and generate what? Ci, here CH3, here CH3, here CH3. So this will be generated. Okay. So you can see here I minus is generating on those carbon which is more stable. So your 3 degree carbocation is more stable. So finally I has attacked on those carbon which is more stable. Because I told you, this oxygen is having the plus charge. And oxygen is an electronegative element. So an oxygen electronegative element plus charge doesn't look good. So this oxygen starts to attract the electron. It will start to attract the electron either from this carbon, or it will start to attract the electron either from this carbon. If it attracts the start to electron from this carbon, CH3 plus will be formed. And if it starts to attack the electron from this carbon, this 3 degree carbocation will be formed. And we know that 3 degree carbocation is more stable than CH3 plus. So this oxygen will starts to attract the electron from this, and there will be generation of 3 degree carbocation. So the 3 degree carbocation will react with I minus and forms what? Tertiary butyl iodide. Clear this part? So here see, 3 degree is more stable. So I minus will attack on those species which form stable carbocation. So here there was 3 degree and 1 degree. So 3 degree was more stable. So I minus has attacked on the 3 degree carbocation. Understanding? Clear this part? Clear? Okay. So now next case, in that next case only, if one of the alkyl group is benzyl, then what to do? We will see this. If it is a benzylic group. Understood, no? Now you will see the benzyl. So your benzyl also SN1 only. See how. I hope you have taken the screenshot. If one of the group is benzyl, if one of the group is benzyl, then which mechanism? SN1 mechanism. Why? In SN1 mechanism, I minus will attack on those species which forms a stable ion. Now this benzylic cation is stable. Why? See, this is, I told you, this is not aryl. Now this is benzyl. So if it is attached to carbon, benzyl attached to O, aryl. So CH2, so now it is 1, 2, 3, 4, O, CH3. So CH2, O, CH3. Okay. Now, if I want to generate the benzyl cation, so because here I am telling carbocation means I have to generate a positive ion. So I will cleave in this way, CO cleavage. And here there will be formation of benzyl cation CH2 plus. Now this CH2 plus is a resonant stable species, because this CH2 plus, okay, this is nothing but benzyl cation. Benzyl cation. Okay, now this benzyl cation is more stable because of resonance. See, this is CH2 plus. This CH2 plus is in need of an electron. So this bond will shift here, then this bond will shift here, then this bond will shift here, and it will show the resonance. So remember one thing, due to resonance, benzyl cation is more stable. Benzyl cation is more stable. Therefore, I minus will attack on benzyl cation. This is a very important key point, that I minus will attack on benzyl cation, because benzyl cation is a stable species, and whenever it follows the SN1 mechanism, and in SN1 mechanism we are telling that I minus should attack on the species which is more stable. But here there is a formation of benzyl cation, and benzyl cation is more stable due to resonance stability. So when due to resonance stability benzyl cation is more stable, so I minus will attack on the benzyl cation. Clear this part? So if any one of the group is benzyl, then remember SN1 mechanism it takes place, and SN1 mechanism I minus will attack on those species which forms stable carbocation, but now it is a benzyl. So benzyl cation, I minus will attack on benzyl cation, because benzyl cation is more stable. Why benzyl cation is more stable? Due to resonance. It can resonate. So when resonance stability, resonance gives the stability. So benzyl cation is more stable. So I minus will attack on the benzyl cation. Take a note, we will go with one example. Clear this part? Okay. See. Case 2 only, if benzyl is involved, then also SN1 mechanism. Okay, clear this part? Now see here, one example I will take, directly with mechanism only I will show you. First we will see how to do the reaction. Okay. So, plus HI. So, I minus will attack on benzyl cation. How I can form benzyl cation? If I do this way, methyl cation will be formed. So, I will cleave in this way. So this I minus will attack on this CH2. So what I will form? I will form this. This species will be generated. So this will be my answer, because I minus will attack on benzyl cation, and if I cleave in this way, then only benzyl cation will be generated. And which mechanism? SN1 mechanism. SN1 mechanism. Clear this part? See here, I will show the mechanism. Okay? Now see. CH2 OCH3 plus HI. So here H plus I minus, here there are two lone pair. So this lone pair will be donated to this hydrogen. So what it will be generated? It will be generated CH2 OH CH3 here plus, and here there is one lone pair. Now see here. Now this O is an electronegative element. Now this O is an electronegative element, it will start to attract the electron either from this CH3 or from this here. Now it starts to attract the electron from this CH3. So here CH3 plus will be generated, and if it starts to attract the electron from this, so this will be generated CH2 plus. Who is more stable? This is a benzyl cation, and this benzyl cation will be more stable. Why more stable? The reason is due to resonance stability. So this will be more stable. When this is more stable, so this oxygen will start to attract the electron from this carbon, because stable species only will be formed. So this will be the generation CH3
OH plus CH2 plus.
Now in second step, this I minus will come to do the reaction with CH2 plus. So this I minus will react from here and forms what? CH2. Clear? Because I minus will attack on those species which is more stable. Here benzyl catenin, benzyl catenin is more stable than the CH3 plus. This reaction will take place. This reaction is which kind of reaction? SN1, SN2, SN1 or SN2. There is a generation of carbocation. Yes, there is a generation of carbocation. So this mechanism is SN1 mechanism, not SN2, because in SN2 there will be no generation of carbocation. Clear? So this is nothing but your benzyl cation. Clear this part? Clear? Case number 3. So make a note, case number 3. Chalo. Start to take a screenshot, okay, because I will rough the part. Okay, within 2-3 days, this chapter will get over. So make a note. Make a note if 2 degree carbocation is involved. If either one of the alkyl group is 2 degree. Okay. So see here. I'll go with case number 3. If any one of alkyl group, if any one of the alkyl group is 2 degree. So there I told you, no, it can follow both either SN1 or it can follow SN2. Now in SN1, generation of carbocation. I will not show the mechanism. I have shown the mechanism, so I will not show the mechanism. Directly answer I will show you. Generation of carbocation. So generation of carbocation means I minus will attack on stable species. Okay, stable cation. And you know 3 degree, 2 degree, 1 degree, 3 degree is more stable and phenyl cation is more stable. Phenyl benzyl cation is more stable. Okay. Second, in the presence of whom? In the presence of the solvent like alcohol, water and ethanol. This you have to remember. SN2 mechanism. So there will be no formation of carbocation. So when there is no formation of carbocation, so I minus will attack on alkyl group where there is a less crowding, alkyl group where there is less crowding, where there is a less crowding, and who will show this? Acetone. If the solvent is acetone, then this mechanism will take place. So this is very complicated. So it is not usually asked in the exam. It can ask in the competition exam, I don't know. Remember, I have 2-3 examples that will show and then we will wind up the lecture. Okay. So see here. And this is also a protic solvent also, okay. This is also known as a protic solvent. And this is also known as a polar protic solvent. This is a polar protic solvent, okay. Some name is given, I don't know. I remember this name. But instead of this polar protic, instead of this you remember, okay, 2 degree and SN1 and SN2. SN1 when? SN1. Water and ethanol. So here 1 means here 2 reagent. There 2 means here 1 reagent. In this way remember. Okay. Chalo. Can I go for next one example? Then we will see each an example. Okay. So don't know this man. Okay. Chalo. So. So if and see here. I am taking here C. OCH3. Here C. CH3. CaCH3. That's it. Here this one. Okay. This is 2 degree, no? 2 degree, yes or no? If any one of is 2 degree, so this is 2 degree only, no? So this is 2 degree. O containing carbon, that is one of the 2 carbon, so 2 degree. Okay. So first, I am reacting with this HI, and I am reacting with HI, and if I take here water or ethanol, then remember 2 reagent means SN1 mechanism, or if I take here acetone, then here SN2 mechanism. Okay. In SN1 mechanism, there will be generation of carbocation, and I minus will attack on those species which is forming the most stable carbocation. So this is here CH3 plus, it will form, or it will form CH3 H plus will form. Now this is 2 degree carbocation, so this will be more stable. So I minus will attack here. When I minus will attack here, what the compound will form? This compound will be forming CH3 Ci, here H, and here CH3. So I minus will attack here, and H will attack here. So here methanol will be generation. Okay, you can name, give the name is 1,2-methyl iodide. 2-methyl methane, the prop, okay, ethyl iodide. Okay, next here. If it is SN2 mechanism, so in SN2 mechanism there will be no generation of carbocation because it is a acetone. So when SN2 mechanism, there will be no generation of carbocation, and when no generation of carbocation, I minus will attack on those species which less crowding. See, so here there is a less crowding, here there is a more crowding, yes or no? Here more crowding, so more steric hindrance. Here there is less crowding, so less steric hindrance, no, less crowding. So I minus will attack on those which have a less crowding. So here is a less crowding. So this I will react with this CH3 plus, according to SN2, no? No carbocation means I minus will attack on those carbon which has a less crowding. Here this, you see this and this, where is the less crowding? This is the less crowding. So here I minus will attack, means CH3 I will be forming, and plus O is with that. So what will form? COH, CH3, CH3H. Okay, so propane 2 will be generated. Clear? So this will be the mechanism. Clear? So it is not given in your textbook, but I have to show, so I am showing this. So that's it. So here your one type of a chemical properties of ether is over, related to CO cleavage. In the next class, I will move to the next chemical properties. Till then, take a screenshot and study well. Thank you.